Greetings, everyone, and welcome to another episode of Franz's Fine Dining. God, I never thought that this would grow into its own series, but here we are! So, this is the Green Papaya. It's a Lao Thai restaurant which I visited during my recent trip to America earlier this month. It doesn't look like much on the outside, but the quality of the food here was fantastic. Here's a look at the menu. And one of the first things you'll probably notice about this menu is the fact that it's very large and extensive, and there's a tremendous amount of variety. As to the dishes themselves, they're a fairly even balance of Thai and Laotian influences, a lot of coconut milk, a lot of lemongrass, some citrus, some peanut, very typical ingredients for that part of the world. And, I mean, it's not a surprise, you use what's local because that's what you have access to, and I felt that the food here was very authentic on the whole. So, there's something on this menu for everybody. You can get traditional dishes like pad thai, or you can also go for things like curry or stir fry, or even duck or seafood if you want it, because they have that here as well. Some of the menu items are listed as being spicy, but to my taste, they're all reasonably mild, so this is a pretty safe place to eat, unless you're the kind of person who orders a crate of boot jalokia and eats them like apples. So, a pretty good family restaurant, I would say. Here we have a glass of sweet Thai iced tea. Now, there are different variations of this type of tea all over East Asia, and whichever country you go to, Korea, Singapore, Malaysia, Vietnam, Thailand, Laos, each will have its own variation. Ordinarily, I don't like sweet foods or drinks, but this one was actually really well balanced. It was sweetened, I think, with condensed milk, and the tea they used as a base was just smoky and earthy and deep and rich and a really, really wonderful tea. This is an order of curry puffs, and what these are is a really crisp, flaky pastry crust filled with curried chicken and potatoes, and next to it there, that relish that comes with it, is diced fresh vegetables in a very slightly sweet vinegar with some kind of seasonings that I couldn't really place. Not 100% sure about that, but really, really tasty. This is Penang curry. It's a savory curry in a coconut milk base with chicken. In this case, you can order it with other types of meat as well, or even with shrimp if you want. I ordered it with chicken, and it has these just wonderful selection of vegetables in it. It's got peas, carrots, peppers, basil, all sorts of fresh vegetables, just a really wonderful curry. It's meant to be spooned over rice, so there's a healthy helping of rice along the side. This is, I think it was called the Tiger Cry, that's how it was listed on the menu. It's a sliced grilled flank steak, very tender, very, very tasty steak, and it comes with a sauce of slightly spicy, I think it was a vinegar with chili and sliced scallions, and the steak itself was very smoky and just a really excellent grilled steak. This here is a salad, a fresh seasonal salad with fresh squid, and the dressing on this was fairly spicy. Again, it seemed to be a vinegar base, very different from the other types of vinegar bases I'd had here, but really, really excellent salad overall. Some cilantro in it, and just all the vegetables were so fresh. Here is dessert. And as you guys probably are already aware, again, I'm not a fan of sweet things, but I ordered this just to give you guys an idea of what sorts of desserts this place offers. It was listed on the menu as a Thai custard, but in reality it turned out to be more of a bread pudding, with two scoops of coconut ice cream on the side, in fact. Not bad, definitely a really nice pudding. It had slices of fresh papaya and mango in it, and the pudding itself seemed to have been made with coconut milk as a sweetener, so it was very mildly sweet, something I had no trouble eating even. And the orange was just very cleverly sliced and very nicely presented. So, really, really excellent place. If you're in Canton, I highly recommend you stop by and try it out. Thank you guys for joining me. I hope you've enjoyed this, and I'll see you all next time.